Hey guys, let's talk about brushes. So I want to introduce them to you. I didn't really talk about them in the last module, and some of you guys had questions because you noticed that they existed when you played around with this number two dress in the brush CAD library. Maybe some of you guys didn't even notice at all, and that's totally fine too, but I did have some questions. So I figure now's a great time to talk about brushes because you're actually going to be creating brushes to make a zipper and also to make some overlock stitching in this module in the upcoming assignment. So right now I see the brushes tool. It's right over here on the right hand side, but if it's not there, you can always go up to window and click it from window. Usually I have to go there, but Illustrator kind of smart menus where they try to guess what you want. So sometimes it's over here, sometimes it's not. Okay, so this file that I did give you, honestly, it was kind of a messy file. I feel bad. I should probably go clean it up for you. But I did pull this CAD from WGSN, and I really hope you guys have been using WGSN because that's a great way to build your library, by the way. Anyways, I digress. So when I copied this CAD, it ended up copying a whole bunch of brushes, which is really confusing. It'd actually be better if there's like only one. But anyways, let's see here. What's going on? So when I click, I'm going to hit Z to zoom in for you. Let's zoom in more, shall we? There we are. So I'm going to click the letter A, and I'm just going to select one of these guys. Okay, it looks like it's this brush right here, Art Brush 71. Okay, so this is an art brush. So what's so neat about it is that it makes the end of my anchor point like pointy, right? So maybe I'll compare it to this one right here. And what I'm going to do with this one, I'm just going to say remove brush stroke. It's selected so I can do that. So you can see now it's no longer pointy, like compared to this one. It's very sharp and stylized, which is so great and just gives a little bit more depth to this very flat CAD drawing. Well, flats are flat, but every once in a while we want it to be a little bit more stylized. Looks a little nicer. So this is a real easy way to do it. So how we did this is that an artist from WGSN, where I got this CAD, they drew a brush. And you can draw a brush too, okay? So if you don't have this, you can draw it yourself. I'm going to click drag, and I'm going to pull it out so you guys can see it. So somebody drew this weird shape with the pen tool. They used the pen tool. Sorry, let me scooch. There we are. And they drew an object with, what is this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 anchor points. That's all they did, okay? So watch, I'll draw it right now with the pen tool. Click, 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 click. Okay, that zero closes my shape, in case you didn't know. Right now I drew something and it has no stroke, no fill. I want it to have a black fill. So I'm just gonna hit the eyedropper and copy this guy. Apparently this guy has a black fill and a black stroke, has an outline as well. Okay, so my shape is a little funny. So I can always get my white arrow, can't I, right? You guys know about the white arrow. Whoa, I hit the down arrow. And that was a little much. Okay, how if I zoom in a little more? Because I'm gonna hold the space bar to pan. Okay, letter A. All right, now we're in a little more control. Now that I've zoomed in, maybe I make this guy a little bit bigger. Is it kind of looking like that one? Okay. So, I mean, if you're ever in a file, you can just make this shape really quick yourself. Or you can save this file and always copy and paste it to another file. So, okay. Anyways, once you draw your shape, you can turn it into a brush stroke. Okay. So I'm going to click and drag, and I'm going to drop it in the brush palette. So just drop it in. Now, when you make a new brush, you have three choices. You can do scatter, art, or pattern. In this class, for fashion design, you're going to use art brush or pattern brush. Between you and me, you're mostly going to use pattern brush. That's where it repeats something, like for our stitches. But in this case, it's a stylized line. We would do art brush. So it's almost like it's the shape of, like, if you bought a paintbrush from the store, it's kind of like the shape of the tip. So if you like were to click and drag, if you were to put paint on your paintbrush and drag it along a piece of paper, it'll make a stroke like that. And then at the end will be kind of sharp. I'm not sure if that's making sense. It's kind of overwhelming, but in this case, I want an art brush. So I say, okay, art brush. I just leave stroke to fit the stroke length. There's some options. Naming it's always maybe a good idea. New paint brush, whatever you want to call it. You can make it bigger or smaller. You can make the width go thinner and bigger. I would leave all of it. The only thing I would change for us in fashion design is the color. So Illustrator defaults to leave your brush the color that you made it. So if you made it black, it'll always stay black. Even if you go over here and change your stroke color, it's gonna stay black. Or if you make it pink or red, it'll always be that color. I don't know, maybe in other industries that's great and really handy. But I think for us, we like color and we like changing our color. So, but I mean, again, maybe a shadow like that, maybe it should always be black. And this is kind of up to you to figure out. But usually you wanna change the color. So to change the color, you do it under the colorization menu. Defaults to none. Okay, so that means it won't change. So all you have to do is change it to tints. I'm not gonna go through explaining all of this. You guys can Google it yourself if you want more information, but for our class, just switch it to tints and you'll be able to change the color. Say okay. So now, just so you know, the default ones, none of them were changed to tints. So if I were to click what's already drawn on this dress, I'm using the white arrow, I'm gonna hold shift, I'm gonna click a few of them. I have about four clicked. Okay, it doesn't even know what color they are. Apparently they're different colors, but they all look black. Let's say I change it to red. I want them all red. Well, it says they're all red according to this stroke, but they don't really look red to me, right? So, okay, so I'm just gonna double click one of these. I guess that's which one they are. And if I change it to tints, applied strokes, now they're all red, right? Okay, so I made my new one. My new one is new paintbrush. Mine's at the bottom. So let's test mine out. I'm gonna change this to bright blue. Okay, so my line's blue, and if I click it, now it's stylized and it's kept it blue because I clicked on the colorization, changed to tints. So that is an art brush. It clicks and drags it. Okay, well, what would it look like if I actually made it a pattern brush? Okay, so let's click and drag this guy, drop it in, pattern brush. Okay, let's do test pattern brush. Okay. We have some options. Talk about it later. Oh, you know what? I didn't do the color thing. Should have done the colorization thing. Okay, whatever. Okay, so now I'm going to click maybe this one because it's kind of long. And it's going to organize it, I think, down here. So it kind of groups the art brushes at the top and puts the pattern ones at the bottom. And look how different it looks. So see, it just repeated my shape is all it did. So that's the difference between an art brush. This is what it looks like as an art brush. And this is what it looks like as a pattern brush. So art brush, it just pulls it out. And pattern brush, it just repeats it. Okay. So if I want my color back, I can double click on my brush and I can say tints. Okay. Yes, apply. And boom, it's red. Okay. So you're gonna need to do pattern brush when you guys are making your zipper. Okay, so you'll see in the video I use the pattern brush, you'll learn it then. Because when you make a zipper, you need different teeth, and you don't want to draw 100 teeth. You just want to draw one or two and make a pattern and then have your zipper go along the line. Okay. So that's my little, I guess, lecture about pattern brushes. I guess, oh, one other thing I can tell you, people ask, oh, can I save it? Well, okay, yeah, we made these great brushes. They're here. But if I go File, New, why is this taking a long time? Let me try it again. Oh, there it goes. Create. Okay. Here we have a blank document. Ah, my brushes are gone. Ugh. Okay. So this is why it's great to have a library. So if there's a brush you like from a past style, I'm just gonna hit the white arrow. I'm gonna hit click, hold shift, click, command C, go to my new file, hitting the tab for my new file, command V to paste. Okay, there are my brushes and automatically, yay! My brushes are now in my brush library. And you know what? I can even delete them from my artboard, and then they stay in my brush palette. So when I save my file, they'll be there. But if I open up another new file, guess what? Gone. So if you end up working really hard and you're like, okay, I love this brush palette I got here. I got so many great brushes. I don't want to lose them. You can save it. So how do you do that? You go to brushes and you click the little sandwich and you scroll down and you say, save brush library. Here's the hard part, is remembering where you're saving it. So get organized. Find a place to save it. Okay, maybe you have a folder for Santa Ana College. And then maybe make a new folder. Illustrator brushes. Create it. Maybe this is stitches. Save. File organization. An ongoing lesson. Okay, so now let's go to my new file. So instead of copying and pasting everything, let's just open the saved thing. So hit the little sandwiches and the brush thing. Open brush library. You know, this is kind of fun to play around. Illustrator has some default ones. I kind of like the, under artistic, they have like watercolor, just kind of fun, and paintbrushes and ink. I digress. Let me get back on topic here. Other library. Where did I save it? Do you guys remember? Sack. I made a sack folder. Illustrator brushes. Double click. Boom. There it is. Open. Yay! There it is. Oh, look. There's a bonus one. I didn't even... Oh, they kind of separated them for some reason. Cool. And look at this. I got my shearing brush. This is another pattern brush. This is cool. So, like, let's say there's like elastic around the waist, right? Hit that. Let's make that a little bigger. Where's my stroke? I don't see my stroke. I'm gonna hit window, stroke. Right, there's my elastic. So instead of drawing all those squiggle lines forever, I can just draw a couple of them and make a brush. And then maybe, I don't, you know what? A double hem, that's kind of good. Let's say you have like a double hem at the bottom of your dress. It's kind of handy to have. Oh, you know what? It doesn't work unless you select your object, by the way. My object wasn't selected. So the computer's like, where do you want the double hem? I don't know. You got to tell it. So it's selected, computer. This is where I want the double hem. Click. Ooh, it's teeny tiny. I want to make it bigger. I guess I could zoom in, but there's my double hem. These single hems, you know, some people like the brushes. I don't. I like, here, I'm going to get rid of that. I'm going to hit right click. Remove. Oh dear. Where's that? I want to get rid of my brush. Oh, may have to do it over here. I have to do it. Oh gosh, now I have two brush palettes. Here. That's kind of confusing. I'm glad that happened. Remove brush stroke, right? I personally am all about the dashed line. I love it. You can, because then you can just change it to how you want it. You can make it round. Maybe I do 12 in this case because it's so big. I don't know. Oh, is this like, yeah. You know, I think there's more control in the stroke panel to do those single dash lines, but I don't know, maybe just whatever. There's Illustrator, million different ways to do the same thing, right? Okay, so that's a lot about brushes. If you guys have more questions, I'm all ears. And I hope that you understand brushes, and I hope that you get some good practice using them, making your zipper and some stitches this module. All right, let me know if you guys have questions.